Hey everyone, and as an update, it's been about 2 days since we started running this basic strategy. And I wanted to show you what happened since we made the change yesterday, about 24 hours ago, to change a resolution from 15 minutes refresh time at tighter spreads to 30 minute refresh times and wider spreads. So this is what the market looked like. Oh, I'm sorry, let me pull that up. Oh, there you go. So this is what the market looked like right as we're about to make that change. So yesterday around 9 a.m., we changed from 15 to 30, and so and widened the spreads out. And this is what happened to the market since then. So if you look at it, kind of like dragging here, so the market has continued in a range-bound fashion for the rest of the day. And then yesterday evening, Pacific time, the market dropped significantly from 9,600 to 9,300. So let's take a look at how our bot responded to that change. So I think the best way to see this is kind of like overnight. Last night, because the bot prints whenever it submits an order, so you can see kind of here, there's a bunch of trades that it had here. So I see buy and sell. And then running the history command, we can see that the first 13 trades were done up until the change. And so these four trades, these five trades, were the ones that were done last night. And we can see that the buy and the sell price, the alternation did actually happen where it was making money on these buys and sells. And because of that, our net P&L has gone from negative 20 cents to negative 3 cents total. So last night, the bot actually made 17 cents, you know, inclusive of fees. So this is a... I would say this is a sign that the changes that we made yesterday to the bot did help the strategy. I would not call it a conclusive success by any means, but I think that was a successful iteration because it showed that a wider refresh time, a longer refresh time and wider spreads helps to is a more appropriate setting for the type of market that we're in right now, which is one that's a little more volatile than the one that existed maybe 2 days ago. So I think kind of in recap, building a strategy is really an iterative process of looking at the market, testing a hypothesis, and then rinsing and repeating. And I encourage everyone to think about their strategy as kind of like a view as to how your bot will behave against the market and continue making a series of decisions that you would as a human, you know, and rather than simply optimizing a set of parameters without looking at what's happening in the market alongside of it. So I hope that helps. I'll make a lot of future videos that go into more in-depth areas on each of our kind of like respective parameters. But I hope this video helped you guys think about how to just create a very basic strategy. Thanks.